Well, there is a new twist to Kerala relief aid politics. What we are picking up is that the government of UAE says that they have not made any offer for aid officially yet. Now, this comes after there was a massive debate over whether or not India should accept the 700 crore rupee foreign aid assured by UAE for flood-ravaged Kerala. So this looks like another major twist in the entire story. Earlier, we were given to believe that 700 crore rupee aid has been promised by UAE to India, but the Indian government, it seems, was reluctant in accepting that aid, contrary to what the demand was from the Kerala government. Let's go across to Paul Ooman. He has more developments really on the story. Paul, what has happened? What has really brought about this twist in the entire saga? It seemed that there was a divide between the state government and the center government on whether or not India should accept aid from the UAE. Now we are given to believe that there was actually no such offer.
Well, Preeti, in Kerala, the waters have receded, but doesn't seem like the political slugfest will come to end anytime soon, because over the last couple of days, we have been seeing the state hitting out at the centre saying that you should accept funds that are coming in from UAE and other countries that are willing to help. The centre saying that we will not be accepting any kind of foreign donation. Ever since 2004, we haven't accepted, be it the Uttarakhand floods, the Kashmir floods, Kashmir earthquake. It is going to be the same. We accept the fact that you are ready to contribute to this particular devastation that has happened, but we reject it very kindly. That was the attitude of the centre, and we have also seen voices like Kodiyeri Balakrishnan, the state secretary for the CPM, saying that if the centre does not accept funding that is coming in from UAE, then the centre will have to compensate by giving the equivalent amount to the state. Also voices saying that why is Kerala being ignored? Is it not part of the country? We also saw protests by people break out in several parts of Kerala saying that the centre considers stepmotherly treatment is being meted out to the people of Kerala.
But it's surprising before that this entire controversy broke out, we need to really go into the details of where exactly did this offer come from, and how come now we are given to believe that this offer never really was there as far as the UAE is concerned. I'm going to go across to our National Affairs editor, Srinjoy Chaudhary. He's joining us on the phone line for more on this story. Srinjoy, first of all, there was this talk of a massive 700 crore rupee aid coming in from the UAE, which the central government here in India was reluctant to accept because this is not our policy. What has happened now? How come we are now being told that this offer never existed? Was it a deliberate design to divide, to bring a divide between the state and central government here in India?
Well, the important point is that even UAE officials have said that this 700 crore figure is not an accurate one because that has not been decided finally. So no decision has been made by the UAE government to offer 700 crore. We know that the equivalent of the Prime Minister's Relief Fund in the UAE has collected money and so on. But whether that has been offered, that exact amount has been offered formally or not, is not clear. What we are hearing from the UAE officials is that that exact figure is not a clear figure. Secondly, no formal formal request has been made to the Indian government to receive the money as aid. So these two points are absolutely clear. The important point, of course, is that the Indian government, as you rightly said, has said publicly, and even before that, or not just for this, but earlier, that India will not accept foreign aid in such situations.
Yeah, so now, Srinjoy, if we were to look at these developments, you know, who exactly could have played this divisive card? What purpose does it really serve to bring this sort of a division in opinion between the state government, that is the government of Kerala, and the central government on a major policy issue like this?
It'll be important to find out that who actually announced this 700 crore. Did the state government make the announcement? The centre certainly did not. Did the UAE government did it? It does not look like the UAE government made the announcement. So these may have been very preliminary discussions, but no formal request to receive aid by for India has been made.
Okay, Srinjoy, if I can just request you to stay with me, I'll go back to Paul Ooman and try and check with him. Paul, where exactly did this initial figure come from? How did we get to know that there is an offer from the UAE to give us an aid amounting to 700 crore rupees, and the state government of Kerala was almost desperate to get that money, so much so that they've been going out publicly holding press conferences one after the other, suggesting how the state really needs that money and how the government in India is not right in its position on not accepting that money from UAE.
Well, Preeti, there were all kinds of rumors during the rounds that UAE has offered the money, and very soon we thought it was confirmed when the Chief Minister himself held a press conference here. Pinrai Vijayan held a press conference here saying that UAE is no other country. It's a very close friend of Kerala, because a lot of Malayalis happen to live and work there for the development of the UAE. So he said, it's no other country. It's a very close friend of ours, and the nations standing up for each other at times of distress is nothing but natural. India has stood up for several countries, and it's quite natural that they would be lending a helping hand. So the centre should accept the offers made by UAE.
Yeah, all those sort of excuses were given in accepting aid from UAE, saying that it's a friendly country and we should at least make an exception this time around. Stay with me, Paul. I'm joined on the phone line by activist Rahul Ishwar. Rahul Ishwar, it seems that there was some sort of a design here to really bring the state government to face the central government on this major policy issue on two different, they would be standing and facing each other on a matter which is so important to the country. Here, the Chief Minister of Kerala was misled, and ultimately the central government, the NDA government at centre, was shamed over an offer which perhaps now we are knowing never existed.
Absolutely. That kind of reports are emerging. Maybe there was a communication gap. If we understood from social media and especially official verified profile Twitter of CMO that a very prominent Malayali businessman called Mr. M.A. Yusuf Ali was talking with the UAE authorities and they were offering this. Maybe if there was a communication gap, we need to correct it. And we have already taken, the existing number of Malayalis have taken a very principled position that central government is helping us a lot. We shouldn't demean central government by comparing or contrasting with any other fund, even if it is there or even if it was not offered. Maybe some kind of communication gap happened. I seriously hope Kerala Chief Minister Sri Pinrai Vijayan come out and open and clarify the position.
Rahul, it was the Chief Minister of Kerala, Mr. Vijayan, who held a press conference, publicly said that if we have such an offer from UAE, then the government of India must make an exception in its policy decision, in its policy which was put in place in 2004, that we do not take aid from foreign countries. He went public with an offer which was not even given on paper. There was no written communication. Isn't it also a bit irresponsible on his part?
I hope Sri Pinrai Vijayan, who usually, I am a right-leaning person, he's a left-leaning chief minister, but still, we all respect him for the measure of words he say. It was unexpected of him. I hope he clarifies immediately, because when a national channel like yours responsibly reports it, I hope he will take care of it, cognizance of it, and clarify the position.
Right.
The people are totally into relief activities, and we were thinking it was a great aid. No, we shouldn't be cheated. We shouldn't be feeled, we feel cheated at the end of the day. So I hope that clarification will come from Chief
Minister. And we're not going to allow the world to take us for a ride in a critical situation like this. The state of Kerala deserves all attention, and the central government is providing it every measure possible to really help the flood-ravaged state to come back and start functioning in a regular way. Thanks very much, Rahul Ishwar and Paul Ooman, for joining us on this story.